Hi, it's Florian, and today I'm going to talk about why I quit coffee, how I quit coffee, what the effects were, and what my thoughts about caffeine in general are. So stay tuned. I quit coffee because I watched a video on YouTube of someone who quit coffee, and he talked about that he went to bed in the evening and was tired, and then got up in the morning and was even more tired until he had a coffee. And I pretty much described what I felt. So I went to bed, I had the feeling that I slept enough, I got up and I was tired until I had a coffee. And that is not normal, I thought, because it can't be normal. Usually the most refreshing thing you do is sleeping, and then you wake up and you should be awake after a few minutes and not need anything to wake up as a human being. So I quit coffee, and I quit it. Basically the next day. I watched the video in the evening and I thought, next day I will not drink coffee. And that's what I did. And it worked out fine until maybe 4 o'clock in the afternoon. And then I started to feel dizzy. I started to feel a headache. And it increased a lot until the evening. So I felt severe headaches. I felt sick. My legs started to hurt. It was horrible. It was like a mixture between a hangover and a jet lag. Very, very bad. I couldn't concentrate. I was just going to bed at 7 o'clock or something like that. And then I slept until, I don't know, 8 or 9. And when I woke up, I still had a headache. I was still feeling sick. I still couldn't concentrate. It seemed that my brain stopped working. I couldn't even focus on maybe a short email or so. It was very, very bad. And so day two was not as bad as the day one, but it was still bad. Same as day three and day four. So they were all dizzy, headache, not able to focus, to concentrate. The brain just didn't work. That's how you can call it. It's just as if someone set a virus in your brain and everything is messed up. And that for the first 4 or 5 days, that was actually the state of mind that I had. And then it went better. So the fog lifted a bit. And second week was way better. I still had some headaches. So they remained, but the dizziness went away. And then in week three, it was okay. So it took me basically 2 weeks to get rid of coffee. And in week three, I experienced how good it is to get rid of coffee. And that's what I'm going to talk about right now. What I noticed is before, my sleep rhythm was messed up. So I went to bed at 10, sometimes at 1 o'clock in the morning, at 2 o'clock in the morning. It just shifted for maybe 4 hours back and forth. And then if I had to work, I needed to get up early and I was tired the whole day. If there was a weekend and I went to bed maybe at 1, I could sleep until 9 or 9:30. And it was just messed up. There was no constants in my sleep rhythm at all. And after quitting coffee, that changed completely. Now I get tired at 10 o'clock. I go to bed at 10:30. Every day since week three, it's what I do every day. There's no variation in it, and I get up at 6 or 6:30 in the morning, and I'm awake, and that is very new. So I have a very constant sleep rhythm now. I'm awake, and I don't need any coffee. I don't have the feeling that I need anything to get me started. I'm just there, and that's very, very cool. What's also cool is once I am awake, I am really awake. So it's not that I have these ups and downs with coffee. Like you drink a coffee, you get a push and then you fall back in a hole again and you need another coffee or whatever. Or you just feel tired and that's just gone. I have a very high stability of being awake the whole day until I get tired and go to bed. And that's new. And that's much better because I work in a job where I need to be awake and where I need to concentrate and focus. And that's all better now. So I can now focus for 2, 3, 4 hours without getting tired, without needing a coffee, without feeling that I need a break. It's much better. So coffee didn't give me energy. It took my energy. It gave me withdrawal symptoms that I needed to compensate with more coffee. So whenever you feel that you get tired and need a coffee, then maybe it's not that you are tired because you work too much, but maybe because you drink too much coffee. Just think about that. But what else changed was my digestion. It's also better now. It's also more constant, I would say. It just improved. So these were the major things that improved. I also noticed that my heart rate went down. So I measured my heart rate with a Fitbit, and that decreased by 4 beats per minute constantly. I don't know about my blood pressure because I don't measure it too often. I don't have a high blood pressure, so it's maybe not an issue, but I think it also goes down because caffeine usually increases your blood pressure. Caffeine also increases your sugar levels. I don't measure them either, but I think that's also better. So it has a lot of positive effects, and I didn't experience any negative effect, which is also strange. Usually there are also upsides and downsides to changing something in your life, but I don't know a downside. So not drinking coffee is not really a downside for me. It has just upsides for me. And so it's cool, and I'm happy that I stopped drinking coffee. I can recommend trying it. If it's not for you, just don't. But from my experience, I would really recommend to try quitting coffee. Yeah, that was it about caffeine as a whole. My thoughts about caffeine are, I thought a lot about it during the withdrawal symptoms. What the hell did I drink there? And why did I drink it? And I drank it because everyone drinks it. So I had coffee in the morning because everyone has coffee. It's not strange to have coffee in the morning. It's not strange to have a coffee at lunch. It's also not strange to offer someone a coffee or to buy coffee or whatever. It's absolutely not strange. It's not strange if you drink Monster energy drinks. It's not strange. But it is a drug. So you take something that stimulates your brain, that messes with your sleep, messes with your blood pressure, with your sugar levels. It is a drug. And that causes withdrawal symptoms if you quit it. And I think people are just addicted to it. And I was definitely addicted to caffeine. And it's something that's socially very accepted, to be addicted to caffeine and to drink it every day. And that's fine, because it seems not to kill people, so it doesn't seem to be so severe or have such severe side effects that kill you after a few years, then maybe it wouldn't be so accepted. I don't even know if it's bad for you. There are some studies that say it's even healthy to drink caffeine because it has some healthy substances in it. Then there are studies that say it's unhealthy because it increases the blood pressure and the sugar levels and so on. So there are two sides to it, and those two sides compete to each other. What I can say is that the effects on me, on my sleep rhythm and so on, were basically negative. There wasn't a positive effect. And you can have vegetables to get positive effects of antioxidants or whatever. So for me, it's a very easy thing. I think that the coffee industry or caffeine industry, which might be very big or is definitely very big, has no interest in having a lot of studies to tell you that caffeine might not be so healthy, like industries had with cigarettes and alcohol and even crystal meth. I don't know if you knew, but it was invented by Germans during the Second World War or before the Second World War, and it was commonly taken because it's good to be awake as a soldier, and also the population took it. It was called pervitin then, and it's very healthy. So at that time, people said it was not damaging anything. But from my point of view, every drug that messes with your brain, that you take constantly and not just once in a while, is not healthy. That's what I learned from all drugs that you can think of. Just think of any drug you know, alcohol, nicotine, heroin, whatever. When you take it all of the time, it messes with you. And the same goes with caffeine. That's what I what my thoughts on that is. You can have caffeine, you can have a coffee once in a while, you can have an energy drink once in a while, but if you have it every day and if you compensate the withdrawal symptoms with having more caffeine, think about what you're doing. It might be a good idea to reduce the caffeine you drink or maybe get rid of it. That were my thoughts that I had during quitting coffee, after quitting coffee. Maybe you have other thoughts, then give it a thumbs up or thumbs down, whatever you think, and like and subscribe it, and comment if you have something to say. Thanks for listening, and have a good day. Bye.